Whether you need surgery when you're diagnosed with a brain tumor is an excellent question, because I think there is of course, a common thought that, my gosh, I have something, it's not supposed to be there, I should get it out. And in fact, that's not the case. I would say that a significant portion of people who are found to have something in their brain don't have a procedure initially. Now, it may be that at some point they end up having a procedure, but the timing of that procedure and the timing of, say, medical care or intervention is very dependent on what the MRI scan looks like and what the diagnosis is likely to be and what the natural history or what we can expect of that tumor for that particular person. It's perfectly appropriate to monitor something and wait until it either proves that it's going to grow or change before having surgery. That is certainly the case for more low-grade, benign-type lesions, lesions that are impacting quality of life, impacting somebody's neurologic function, will certainly need a diagnosis and treatment sooner. The kinds of problems that we monitor with regular MRI scans are usually things that are found inadvertently. Somebody has a headache, they get a CT scan, something's found on the CT scan, and then they get an MRI scan. Somebody has a car accident. Because they had a car accident, they get a CT scan, doesn't look right, they have an MRI scan, and they find something, but it's not affecting the person. The likely diagnosis is a very benign type course, and therefore it may be very appropriate to just monitor that lesion. A finding on an MRI scan that suggests a more ominous course or has more implications for the person is certainly something that needs to be addressed sooner rather than later, and it's critical to have a surgeon, an oncologist, a team that is comfortable making those decisions about whether to have surgery now or to monitor it. There are many times where that's not, you know, cut and dry. It's not a black and white situation, and the water is sort of cloudy, so to speak. And only through experience and seeing these problems regularly can one really help the person make the correct decision. And ultimately, it is a joint decision. I mean, I think it's essential that people are educated about their problem, educated about the implications of it, what will happen, so that together a decision can be made about what's best for that person. Because ultimately, that is the most important thing for that person.